In this video, we'll show you how to navigate the TubeBuddy dashboard, the home of some powerful TubeBuddy tools. Hello, TubeBuddies. TubeBuddy has more tools than just those that are on YouTube. And in this video, we'll guide you through the TubeBuddy dashboard. The TubeBuddy dashboard shows off some cool things, and we'll learn about them together. If you'd like to learn how to use more of the TubeBuddy tools to help your YouTube channel, then subscribe and ring that bell today. Now, follow along with me, and let's make our way over to the TubeBuddy dashboard together. If you've signed into the dashboard before and added your channel, you'll see your page like this. However, if you are new to TubeBuddy and haven't added your channel, you'll see the dashboard like this. You'll see our Getting Started series here. The onboarding series will walk you through a lot of great points within TubeBuddy, and I highly recommend you watch that after you're done watching this video. We'll include a link in the description down below. However, let's add our own YouTube channels to the TubeBuddy dashboard. To add your YouTube channel, under the Welcome to TubeBuddy section here, click on the plus channel button here. Once the page loads, be sure to select the Gmail account your YouTube channel is tied to. Once you select that account, be sure to select your YouTube channel and then you'll see this screen. We have a whole video on this screen. To quickly answer, TubeBuddy is safe, but you can click that card on screen to see more on why we need this information. When you're ready, click Allow, and you will be taken to the dashboard with your channel added. On the homepage, you'll see your channel here in the Channels section. We'll cover what you can do here in a second, but we'll move on to the Affiliate Center if you're a part of the affiliate program, or we'll give you a way to join. We'll look below that and see the licenses. You'll also see what license of TubeBuddy, or what level, either the free/starter version, pro, star, or legend version. You can manage it by clicking the Manage button here. Under licenses, you'll see integrations. These are used for our tools that tie into TubeBuddy, like our mobile app, Twitter, Facebook, or the Patreon integration. You can click Manage All, and that will take you to the Integrations page. You can see this page over here on the left-hand side called Integrations. Under Integrations, if you're a paid TubeBuddy user, you can get access to member perks, which are some of the extra benefits of paying for TubeBuddy. Some things in the dashboard are for the paid versions of TubeBuddy, but if you'd like to try them, we'll have a link in the description down below to a TubeBuddy free trial. Now, let's go back to the TubeBuddy dashboard. Once you're done with member perks, you can head back to home and it will take you back to the home page. You can also get back to the home page in the top right-hand corner on any page. You'll also see the TubeBuddy community forums, a great place to meet other TubeBuddy users, and a way to get support in TubeBuddy. The final area is the Your Profile/Sign Out button. If we click Profile, you can change your contact information, see how you'd like to get notifications, get invoices with information, or permanently delete your profile on TubeBuddy. Hopefully, you wouldn't want to do that, but if you want to, that's how you can. Let's go back to the homepage and focus on some of the tools you can access using the TubeBuddy dashboard. It is important to note that depending on the license you have, depends on the amount of tools you get on the dashboard. That doesn't mean the dashboard is useless, just something to keep in mind as we go deeper in this video. For our example, we will show you everything available on the dashboard, but depending on your version, it will visually let you know what you can and can't do on the TubeBuddy dashboard. Let's start with this pro feature, the health report. This feature lets anyone with a paid level of TubeBuddy see the health of their channel in the last 30 days. The health report pulls from YouTube analytics and gives you a quick glance on how your channel is performing. You can see the amount of views, subscribers, and uploads at the top, the performance for the last 30 days, and which unique traffic source, engagement source, and audience source. This is designed to help you easily see how you're doing on YouTube. Health reports lives under the data and insight sections here on the left-hand side. While on the left-hand side, let's click on the channel valuation to see the next part of the dashboard. Channel valuation lets you know how much you can charge for a dedicated upload or shout out on your YouTube channel. This is brought to you by Social Blue Book, which, if you have a paid license with them, you can see here on the TubeBuddy dashboard. Back to the left-hand side here, you'll see our legend level tool, Retention Analyzer, under the channel valuation. Retention Analyzer lets you see how videos across your channel are performing at various time intervals. We have full in-depth videos on a lot of the sections in the dashboard, and we'll link that video in the description down below. Simply put though, Retention Analyzer helps you work to improve overall retention on your videos by identifying the trends in audience viewership. The next section, under Data and Insights, is Usage Stats. This free feature lets you know how much time and money you specifically are saving using the TubeBuddy tools. You can view this as all time or by the last 30 days. This feature will track how much time you're saving using TubeBuddy tools. Ours at TubeBuddy is very high, but we use and test our features a lot. If we choose the base starting pay for us here at TubeBuddy, that's $20 an hour. You'll see that we saved over $500,000 in productivity costs and a lot of time saved. Speaking of saving time, let's go back to the homepage of the TubeBuddy dashboard. Next, we'll take a look at the Launchpad section. Now, this does require a star or higher license, and this lets you see how your videos are performing after uploading them to YouTube. You can start the process by clicking Select Video, but we'll examine a video that's already been run. You can see the video launch status, letting you know if TubeBuddy notices any best practices or opportunities found. Next is the checklist template, making sure you're doing things you need to remember on YouTube. This is similar with the best practice setup, and you can have them actively show up on the YouTube upload page. After that, we show you the opportunities, which gives you a chance to go back and change things in a video to help your video do better. Finally, active monitoring lets you be updated and alerted for videos proactively, checking how they perform after they've been uploaded. Launchpad helps you keep track of your videos after they're uploaded. We have more features that do this, and if we go back to the homepage, we can show them now. These next two features, as I said, let you see how your videos perform after you upload them. Competitor Scorecard does require a legend license, and you can access search rank tracking with the star level license. On the competitors, you can add people you want to track and see how you're competing with them. Here, we have some friends of TubeBuddy, for example. You can add a competitor by clicking the plus add competitor button here. If we head to the left-hand side now, you can see the scorecard, and this will show you how your channel competes with these creators. This data can be used in other places too, like our search rank tracking. And if we look above the competitor section on the left-hand side, we can see this data being used in search rank tracking, which we mentioned earlier. We'll start this section with keywords to track. As the name suggests, these are keywords you want to track. And here, you can see the keywords we have. These should be topics you want to rank for and have authority in around these keyword/subjects. You can add keywords with the Add Keywords button here. You can also see how you're doing for these keywords in the ranking reports on the left-hand side here by clicking on Ranking Reports. You can set up these reports once you enter the keyword and can change when the reports run at the top here. You can also view past reports run, and we will do that now. These reports let you know where you rank in YouTube and Google. They also show you where your competitors rank too. The final thing you can do is scheduling, and you can choose how often you want reports and what date you want the reports to run on. All of this is helpful in helping you see more using TubeBuddy's website tools. To see more website tools, we'll go back to the home of the dashboard. Next is Brand Alerts, a legend level tool that lets you be notified when anyone on YouTube mentions a specific keyword in their video. We at TubeBuddy, of course, track, well, TubeBuddy. After that is our legend level tool A/B testing, where you can test thumbnails and see which ones perform better and lead to more views. Do you want to learn more about A/B testing? Then check out that card on screen to learn more. Next is backups and exports. This legend tool helps you protect yourself against lost data by backing up all your video's metadata. You never want to lose your data. And if you ever need to re-upload your content, TubeBuddy has your back in terms of the metadata for YouTube. You can back up your entire channel, or back up your video since your last backup. You can then view your backups in CSV form by downloading them here. Heading back to the homepage, we're gonna look at canned responses. To set up canned responses, you can set them up here. You get one for free, but have unlimited canned responses with the paid versions of TubeBuddy. Canned responses will show up on the YouTube comments page, but they're added here on the website dashboard, and you can use them to answer common questions, have easy links to other videos, and do whatever you want with them, as long as they're in line with the YouTube Terms of Service, which we'll link in the description down below as well. Next, we'll look at promo materials. This helps you have permanent links to your most recent upload, most popular upload, your channel page link, and other helpful links for free. The final section of the TubeBuddy dashboard is the settings. This lets you change how you use TubeBuddy, and you can show/hide features here. For example, change the search rank method to incognito mode to get the most accurate results on TubeBuddy. There are also ways that you can add more people to use the website tools here at TubeBuddy. Trust us, we know there's a lot here. So we have YouTube chapters in the description so you can jump back to any section of this video. We also have videos linked down there in the description that will help you navigate through it all in the TubeBuddy dashboard. What section of the dashboard do you find yourself using the most? For me, it's probably TubeBuddy's A/B test, but we're curious to what you're using. Do you want to learn how to navigate TubeBuddy on YouTube? Then check out that video on screen. I'm Andrew Camp from TubeBuddy. Now let's go out and start using the TubeBuddy dashboard.